We have Nischal Maheshwari, the CEO of Centrum Broking, who's joining us on the show. Nischal, good morning and thanks for taking the time out. These are tough times to call, but I'm going to start off with a question on the benchmarks, specifically the Nifty. My question really is, if you leave out the top 10 stocks on the Nifty, would you want to go and buy something in the remaining 40, or for that matter, if you could just consider the Nifty 100, would you consider buying, are there opportunities out there in stocks beyond the top 10 or top 15?
So I think that may not be the way I would look at it. Basically, I would actually look at sectors, and within sectors, basically, my view has been very clearly for some time now that you need to be defensive, because I think economic revival will take more time than what market is expecting. And historically, I was just studying the business cycles, and actually, whenever there has been a downturn because of the domestic consumption issue, it takes much longer to revive than external issues. So I think that's why my view remains to be that focus on to the defensive sectors. So whether it is IT, pharma, FMCG, utilities, these are some of the sectors basically which we have been recommending. Now they may or may not be the part of the Nifty 50. Definitely this is the way we go out and recommend stocks to people.
Nischal, good morning. What's your sense on the auto space? You think that obviously the slowdown is there for everyone to see, the monthly numbers that come out. But do you see this slowing down anytime soon? Do you see a bottom coming anytime soon? And what are you recommending your clients in terms of auto? Is that a sector that you would recommend or stay away from?
So I think some amount of bottom fishing is okay basically in this sector, given the valuations. The stocks have corrected quite a bit, and being a cyclical sector basically, I think you are seeing at the bottom of the cycle. So I think in the next one quarter there is very strong chances that the two-wheeler demand may come back, given that we have got a bountiful rainfall. And as you know, around 40-50% of sales of motorcycles happen in the rural side. So if rural has more money in its hand basically, and there is a festive season, so I think this next 3-4 months is very crucial, not only for the auto but the whole economy per se. The whole economy, you are going to see, this is the last chance basically when the economy shows some green shoots. And if it is so, I think revival will start coming in. But I think four-wheelers have some more time to go, and CV is furthest in this cycle. So CV will be the last to recover.
Right, Nischal, we have more and more estimates suggesting that the consumption space, specifically the FMCG company, is likely to post a multi-year low in terms of growth rates, revenue growth rates for FY20. Is that also your reading? And in that case, how would you address this sector going in?
So it's been a surprise. I think some of these companies have shown some very strong volume, basically, if you remember last quarter. Now that may be one of basically, but I still believe that around 7-8% volume kind of a growth across the FMCG looks still to happen. And if there is good monsoon, I think the rural demand will start taking off. So I am not really worried about the FMCG sector's growth. And having said that, I think yes, valuations are challenging, but that's the only place to hide in. At least you have some growth. There is no degrowth happening actually. What you look at in auto is basically 20% fall in numbers, which is steep. At least these guys are still growing. So whether the growth is now low single digits, but that is positive as yet.
Are you telling your clients to start accumulating some of the mid caps, or is it a better idea to just stick to the large caps now?
I believe basically that when large caps are available cheap, why look at mid caps at all? So even in the mid caps, basically SEBI defined mid caps is what I really see is some amount of value is there, Going beyond that, I don't think so. Now is a chance actually to go beyond and start looking for mid cap, because I think large cap itself are pretty cheap.
Right. Well, Nischal, let's talk about technology too. Now, we do know that some of the larger names have indicated a near double-digit growth, if not. Of course, you have the likes of Infosys, which are aiming for around 10% as per the guidance. We have the likes of HCL Technologies, which is well over double-digit growth in top line. In TCS has suggested something like that. But if you consider just the top five or six names, and of course, I understand you can't talk about them individually, but if you just consider the top five or six names, would that be a good space to hide, considering the kind of growth rates that have been projected as compared to the rest of the economy?
Yes, I think that sector is in a good shape. Basically, around 8 to 10% kind of a growth is on an average you may see. Most of the large caps and the larger mid caps doing that kind of a number. Secondly, I think rupee is going to be in favor for them. So rupee has again gone back to around 72, so I think that is in favor for them. And I see the way oil is behaving, I believe the rupee will continue to remain that way. And anyway, it is good for our exports that we are overpriced anyway for our currency. So it is good for our exports that rupee continues to depreciate from here also. So given these circumstances, I believe it's a good place to hide. And you should be overweight IT at least.
About financials, which part of financials is better at this point of time? PSU banks, private banks, or the NBFCs?
No, I think basically we are going back to the old tested private sector banks, which have got granular assets. Those is where you have to be basically, because this is the corporates are still surprising you. I don't see that there is this is going to bottom out in the next 1 or 2 quarters, because now I've been hearing that for 6 quarters, the next 1 or 2 quarters everything is going to bottom out. So it doesn't seem to be, economy is going from bad to worse, so it is better to be sticking around with the granular guys.
All right, well, what about the NBFC space? Because there is a lot of talk and chatter when it comes to, your microfinance companies. So how would you address this? And I'm not talking about some of your very large cap names, something like a Bajaj Finance, If you just consider something like a housing finance or microfinance, is there an interesting play here that you would suggest or advise?
So I think the thought process doesn't change there also. I think it is granular. So the more smaller loans, the more affordable housing, basically that's where you have to be. So whether it is Bajaj Finance or some of the housing finance companies like PNB, LIC, Can Bank, these are all guys basically who are doing 15-20 lakh loans. So the more granular you are, the better it is basically in this kind of a market. Now some of the MFI also should qualify in this basically, given they are also very, very granular. So look at only things basically which are very, very granular in this market basically, because that's where, yes, some of this will go bad, but there will be no chunky thing which is going to come through across. And those 1 or 2 NPAs are manageable. So I think you have to stick to the granular theme.
Okay, and finally, before we let you go, Nischal, what's your sense on the commodity-based counters, be it the oil companies or be it the metal companies? You think that there is still time for the cyclicality to kick in, or you believe that, you know, this is the time to start accumulating?
No, I think it's best to avoid them, basically, because I do not believe that world is looking out for very strong growth. So there's no point in actually trying to accumulate much ahead of the time. So there is lot of time basically to accumulate all these commodities. Wait, there's no hurry there.
Okay, Nischal, we'll leave it at that. Thank you so much for joining us and talking to us here on Bloomberg Quint.